In today's episode, we're going to work with a mixing tool, adding a couple of pictures together. Also, we're going to work with the brush effect to bring some atmosphere to our image. So let's start with by mixing a new image into our composite. We're going to bring this little image right here. We're going to position it. And then we're going to remove areas that we don't need. Basically, what we're going to create with this effect is sort of like a oil spill, just for fun. So we're going to go and use the blending mode, seamless. We're going to position our image in the area that we want and delete areas that need to be removed so it blends perfectly with the image, with the background. As you can tell, that looks like it belongs to that area. You can actually zoom in and fine-tune some of the areas that you need. And that looks perfect. We can go ahead and just apply this. Now we're gonna add another picture. In this case, we're gonna add a cloud to our background for two purposes, just to give it like a disappear the background and also cover that bright light at the end. Repeat the same process. We erase areas that we don't want. And then we start playing with the image and figure out sort of like what we want to do with this. We're gonna do a blending mode seamless again. And then we're gonna start deleting some of the areas that kind of don't want. Also, what we can do is position the image. It's sort of like there. We can bring back some of the background to cover some of that light. See, that's a cool little trick right there. Because that light is too bright. Bright, so we need to kind of cover it a little bit. So that's a nice trick. So with this little button, you can see before and after, and now our picture is looking better. Let me try and reposition it a little higher. There. So now I'm happy with that result. We're gonna go ahead and apply it. Now what we're gonna do, we're gonna actually apply the brush effect to give this image an atmosphere effect look, so it looks like the clouds, it has some haze in it or has some fog in it in the area. Let me add the brush tool, brushes, effects. We're gonna select this effect, it's like the cloud. Then we're gonna play a little bit with the size of it. Make it a little slice and make it a little deposited, so it's there, but it's more settled. So we're gonna apply it in around the image. See how you give area of the clouds a better atmosphere? You can see this like that. So let's go ahead and add another image here. We're gonna grab an ocean because I want to have some sand and some waves kind of like in the front area of this street. I'm going to delete areas that I don't want. Then I'm just gonna remove those hard edges. I'm going to apply the seamless effect again. I'm going to position this image in the area that I really want. It works really nicely there. And we can start bringing back some of the background to blend it nicely. We can try and blend it a little more. So, move it up a little bit, right about there. and erase all the stuff from the street area. There. As you can tell, it blends nicely. Go ahead and apply that. Let's go ahead and add another component to the image. Let's use again the tools mixer. We add our subject to it. Delete the areas that you don't want. We need to zoom in to fine-tune the selection. Just one, our subjects and the surroundings, we can kind of get rid of them. Be careful not to delete important areas of the picture. See, the picture has a low quality, but for what we need, it's gonna work fine. Delete some of the pixels that you don't want. Let's see if that works. And we're gonna leave some of the shadows there because they're gonna work really nice with our foreground. So we try and remove as much as possible. So now what we're gonna do is position our subject where we want it, right there. And we're gonna blend it. I think for this, we're gonna use darken. Darken usually works really nice with silhouette type of images. And another trick is to blend it and bring back some of the background. See? Let me zoom in. If you working with opacity, start bringing those elements from the background in from the foreground, and it looks like the image is belongs there. That looks pretty nice. So that looks great. Let's go ahead and apply that. Now let's give our complete image a look, just to blend everything completely together. Let's go ahead and add a filter. For this case, I believe steel should work nice. I like this look. Let's go ahead and review what we did. First, we started with our base image. We added sort of like a liquid spill, oil spill. We added our clouds and covered the light in the background. We added some atmosphere with the brush effect. We had our foreground, ocean. Then our subject, gave it some color. We save. And we're done. Thanks for watching.